ride fast on the highway. I don't wanna do it alone. Sad boy ain't alone no more. I'm right by his side. We're young, free of fear, and we're feeling alive. But still I see crystal tears.
What is going on, everybody? It's Taylor Roberts, and welcome to Off the Deep End. If you're just joining us for the first time, we're in the middle of a Lady Gaga deep dive where we explore her artistry through her music and music videos, which means new Lady Gaga reactions until we reach the end of her discography. So make sure you subscribe, make sure you hit that bell button so you get notifications of when those new videos drop. Hop on over to Instagram, Twitter, and Twitch. Give me a follow. The new OTDE Discord server is now open, so go join it and join the OTDE community. There's a link to it down in the description of this video. I put out a poll on Twitter to see what kind of alcohol I would be drinking, and you guys voted on tequila. Great. And one more thing before we do this. Also back in August, I posted a GIF on my Instagram and told you guys to caption it. And the winner of that caption contest goes to Alicia Bruce with the caption, "When your grandfather says something low-key racist." But thank you guys for playing. Of course, we're gonna do it again in the future. But let's not waste any more time. Let's hop right into this Art Pop reaction. You're gonna do a shot too?
Yeah.
Okay. As you pour it here like this. Oh, sweet baby Jesus. One.
Don't put a big one.
I'm gonna put the whole thing in there.
No, thank you. It's open.
Two. Alrighty, here we go. First shot down.
Go fast, baby.
Let's go. Woo. Oh, man.
Whoa.
All right, one down. Let's get this shit started.
If you find it, send it straight to Hollywood.
I'm scared. Okay. Goodness gracious.
My hell is protection for the gorgeousness of my face. See the girl who lives behind the aura, behind the aura. Do you want to touch my cosmic lover? Do you want to peek underneath the cover? Do you want to see the girl who lives behind the aura, behind the aura, behind the
those scents, man. Those scents come in and they just fucking blow you away. Holy shit, guys. What an album starter. I'm pretty sure my audio is going to be all pretty, like, distorted just because of, oh, my God. We've reached that EDM phase now. Now, you know, it's creeped its way into the other music that she's made in the past, but this one, it just came here to just fuck your ears, man. Small little buildup before that drop comes in, and when that drop comes in, it just drop kicks you into another dimension. And it doesn't stop. We keep the party going. Let's fucking do it. Hold up. We're building up now. Okay. Here we go. Put your fucking hands up right now, motherfucker. Let's rub it. Break it down. Okay. Jupiter. Mercury. Venus. Uranus. Uranus. Guys, I feel like I've been transported into a different dimension here. And it's not the alcohol talking, it's the music. It's so chaotic and clashy. It's collagey. Collagey. It's collagey. It's a collagey. The more I say collagey, the weirder it sounds for some reason. But it's a very collagey sound. You got a lot of bass and synths going in there, clashing together. But it gives it that kind of urgent, abrupt sound. And it also gives Gaga the opportunity to just showcase her vocals here. I mean, she has to be more powerful than the instrumental itself. You know what I mean? And she definitely did that in this last song.
Greetings, Himeros, god of sexual desire, son of Aphrodite. Lay back and feast as this audio guides you through new and exciting positions.
Sounds good to me. That synth is dirty as fuck.
Like a GUI, I'll lay down face up this time under you.
So this is what I'm thinking during the production of this album, right? Gaga walked into the studio and was like, hey, I'm ready to make my next album. And the producers were like, great, what do you want to do? And she said, I want to ruin everybody's speakers, because that's what these songs do. They are speaker destroyers. Speaker destroyers. Speaker destroyers. Literally, if you, I'm probably gonna have to get some new headphones after listening to this album, just because of just how in your face. It's like getting punched by Mike Tyson three times at the same time. I don't know if that makes, that doesn't make sense, but it perfectly makes sense in the way that I am explaining this song right now. But we are three songs deep, guys. That means it is time for another shot. When I said that I'm like a lightweight, guys, like I'm dead serious. I don't drink really much anymore, so this tequila is going to go right through me. But you guys don't care, right? You guys are here to party. You guys are here to watch reactor YouTuber get fucking shit-faced on camera. And I mean, I'm here for it. You're here for it. We're all here for it. Fuck. Okay. Let's keep this party rolling.
Last night.
That's what I like to hear. I love that line.
But I've had a couple drinks and oh my god.
Me too. I took an extra shot. Cause why not? Right? We drinking straight from the bottle. We don't play around with this bullshit on OTDE. You know what I'm saying? Oh shit. This my shit. T.I. Too Short and Twista? Yeah. You know what it is. Pocket full of number of bands of bill. Expensive and you may find. God damn. The 808s on this song. There's some gangster shit right here. This family is stupid attractive. If you survey the way we've acted, keep it coming. I'm coming around like your friend now. I think this ain't even the weekend. Red carpet, easy. What the fuck, guys? That was such a badass song. Lady Gaga, T.I., Too Short, and Twista. A combination I wouldn't have ever expected. Then again, she did do a song with Flo Rida back on the Fame. But T.I. is way out of the league of Flo Rida. But holy shit, what a bop.
Put some lipstick on, perfume your neck and slip your high heels on. Rinse and curl your hair, loosen your hips and get a dress to wear. I'm the one who's been coming round again loving you. You're my slave. I'm needing you the way you make me feel. I'm long been out of God, you wanna be mad cat. My mom about a cat, she wanna be mad cat. Can you feel it, can you feel it, can you feel it?
I can feel it. I can feel it. Okay. Okay. I'm pausing for a second. Holy shit. Holy shit. I had to regain my composure because this song is wild as fuck. Keep it going. Fucking A, man. Holy shit, the way that song closed out, I'm probably gonna be saying holy shit a lot. That's like my go-to drunk word is is holy shit, but holy shit. This one is different, as in, you know, Born This Way was made for a live performance. This is just made to fucking kill you. It's made so, one, you destroy your speakers. Two, for you to get super shit-faced. Three, do a lot of drugs. And four, die. It's like if a scrapbooker was high on bath salts and decided to make an album. Sonically is what it sounds like. A bath-salted scrapbooker. EDM has always been there, but it didn't really come into the mainstream until around, you know, after 2010. Here, you can tell Lady Gaga took that influence, duh, obviously. But because it was so big, she hopped on that wave, and she rode that wave. And this is basically what this album is riding that new sound, that new wave, but doing it in a way that Gaga can do her signature shit. So I know there's a song on here that got taken off because one of the artists was peeing on people. So I'm gonna do the Christina Aguilera version. So what I might do is, if you guys really, really, really want me to react to the R. Kelly version, I may do it on Patreon. I'll put a vote on Patreon. So if you're a Patreon member, I'll put a poll up on Patreon. You can let me know if you really want me to hear that R. Kelly version of this song. Was that three songs? Yeah, that was three songs. Let me take a drink real quick. Oh my God. Okay. And No limes or salt. Can you write that down in your notebook? Because that's not how we do it here. Did you hear that? Was it the grudge? No, it was just my body saying, "What the fuck are you doing, bro?" Tipsy at the moment.
You're red.
Yes, I am. The wife needed to come in because she wanted some more alcohol. Okay, baby, do it. Surprisingly, this was a slower song than the other songs we have listened to so far, and also very sexually aggressive. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. But what I really loved about it is you have Lady Gaga and you have Christina Aguilera and these two amazing vocalists on the same track. And sometimes when you get a track like this, you have two singers that sing as well as they do. You can almost kind of hear them trying to battle each other on a track. Like, I'm the better vocalist. I'm going to do the more riffs. I'm going to do, you know, the higher notes, etc., etc. Mariah Carey. But here, they both pull their weight. They both collaborate on the song, and it feels fluid, and it feels like more like friends working with each other than opposite singers fighting to have a better part on a song. I don't know what the R. Kelly version sounds like. Again, if you want me to react to the R. Kelly version, I will do it on Patreon, but I'm not going to do it for this video because he pees on people. Nobody likes being peed on. Or some people do. But that's a totally different discussion. That's a totally different topic. We're talking about music right now.
The color palette you
I don't know if I'm feeling this one too much.
Brushes with darkness won't help you create your destiny. I'm self, but our pop could mean anything. We could belong together. Mind, art, pop, you make my heart stop.
Art pop and heart stop. That's just good songwriting. But I don't know, there's something different about this song that I just wasn't vibing with. I just wasn't vibing with for some reason. By the way, I am super fucking red. Let me explain something here real quick in case you're worried about why I look like a fucking tomato. I'm Asian. So when I drink, I get the Asian glow. And if you don't know what that is, my body's enzymes or whatever doesn't break down alcohol correctly. So technically, I'm allergic to alcohol. It's an allergic reaction to alcohol. It sucks because every time I drink, I feel like I just got done running 10 miles in like 105 degree weather. Your face is pulsating. You're hot and sweaty. I'm hot and sweaty right now. Good news is I get fucked up super fast, which means, you know, if I go out to a bar, it's a cheap night. You know what I mean? Spend like $10. Pros and cons, man. Pros and cons. You got to look at the silver lining about things. Can kill those vocals.
I know you want me. You're just a pig inside a human body. Squealer, squealer, squealer. You're so disgusting. You're just a pig inside. Do ya I know.
Oh my god, you guys, y'all better put your fucking hands up right now and fucking throw down with me on this song. This is a time to bond. Let's fucking do it.
Paint your face and paint his face and
I just found my new favorite song, guys. Swine. That song was the shit. You're just a pig inside a human body. Yes, I am. I eat a lot. Does that make me a pig in a human body? This is going to sound weird because this album has just been nonstop craziness since the beginning. But I think I like the pacing on this album better than I did Born This Way because, yes, All of the songs have been super fast, and my biggest thing was about some slow songs to slow stuff down, like I said. But Art Pop and Do What You Want With My Body, in comparison to the other songs on this album so far, have been two of the slower kinds of tracks, which does give you room to breathe in comparison, unlike Born This Way, where everything was kind of the same pace in comparison to the songs to each other until we kind of reached the end with like You and I and things like that. Does that make sense? I hope it made sense. I don't know, guys. I'm pretty fucked up right now. So, pour it up.
I am so fab. Check out, I'm blonde.
Fab.
I'm skinny. I'm rich. And I'm a little bit of a bitch. I wanna dress you up in silk. Tabitha. First can hold my black card and tiara. Versace promises I will. Dolce Vita.
What do you wanna wear this spring? What do you think is the new thing? What do you wanna wear this season?
Everything. Try not to. Try not to.
You just had a salad today. Boulangerie. What do you wanna wear this spring? What do you think is the new
thing? I'm fucked up, guys.
What do you
I'm fucked up. Thank you for 10,000. Nice little POV song about Donatella Versace. And we all know that Gaga loves fashion. And so, of course, she's going to show her love for fashion. She seems to show her love for fashion on at least one song on every album. And this one, it looks like it has two. Donatella and fashion next. This is different. I will say her vocals have been perfection throughout this album, though. Her vocals on this album have just been magnificent. So strong, so powerful, which is needed for an album like this, where it's just constantly in your face, grabbing you by the nuts and squeezing as hard as it can. That's a nut grabbing. It's a nut grabbing album. Fashion, I didn't care for this one either too much. I did love this the last part of the song, when that kind of like keyboard came in just to close out the song, but that was like the last 30 seconds or something like that. Wasn't my cup of tea for sure. I'm debating if I should take one more shot. I'm pretty fucked up already. And I know if I take one more shot, it's probably going to send me over the edge. Yeah, fuck it. You guys are right. Y'all convince me. Okay, that's going to be the one. That's going to be the one. I could be the one. I could be the one. Nope. No, 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 no. We're here for Lady Gaga, not Dua Lipa. Get your shit together, bro. I like where this is going.
Lady of the dumb won't be a slave to the blonde or the culture of the popular.
Can't get over her vocals, man. Can't get over them.
Say it.
Woo-hoo! Light one up, baby.
Quirks off its on. The party's just begun. I promise this. Drink is my last one. I know I fucked up again. I need you more than hope. Need you more.
My heart would break with
I need you more, need you more. I need you more than dope.
Powerful vocals on that song. Not a very good song. Which is weird, because I really, really, usually, I enjoy Lady Gaga's ballads. This one, not so much, though. Not. In fact, I think this is my least favorite song on this album right now. It just feels so out of place. It feels so out of place with just how crazy this album has been, sonically. To throw this in there, even though it's a slow song and it does give you time to breathe, it's just so out of place that it just doesn't fit.
Sometimes the story has no end. Sometimes I think that we could just be friends. Cause I'm a wandering man, he said to me. And what about our future plans? Does the thing we have even make sense? When I got the whole world in front of me. So I said, I don't wanna be alone forever, but I can be tonight. Forever, but I can be tonight. Tonight. So I just packed my baggage.
Why not? That one was like you and I on steroids. Kind of what I was expecting Dope to do was taking a ballad and blending it into the rest of the music. So it does do that well with fitting into the overall album. But I don't know. I think that one's going to have to give me a second listen to.
Applause.
album closes out with the same energy that it opened with. I liked it. It's like a perfect little bookend. Here's how I explain the album. It's like this. It's like... This album sound, it's a mess. This album is a mess, but it's meant to be a mess. It's meant to sound like a mess. It's meant to clash together. Sounds are supposed to clash together. The vocals are supposed to clash together. Clashy, splashy, and dashy. I've been reading the dictionary. I know how to rhyme words. Shit, I should be a rapper. I feel like this album was conceptually produced that way, to be collagey, to be bits and pieces thrown together production-wise. And this is what that album does. I really, really enjoyed this album. And like I said, what set it apart from Born This Way for me is, yes, the songs are loud. They're in your face. It's non-stop most of the time. But there are songs here, the way that this album track list is structured, there are times to breathe. Even though they seem crazy and not slow at all, it's still slower than songs on this album in comparison that give you time to breathe. And then again, on here at the very end of this album, she throws in a couple ballads, which I wasn't really feeling too much. Gypsy was way better than Dope as far as a ballad, but I don't know. I wasn't feeling those ballads on this album, but that's okay because there was a bunch of other songs I was feeling on this album. Applause was a great way to close out the album. Swine, that's my fucking shit, man. Swine is the shit. Do What You Want With My Body is a great song. Jewels and Drugs was a fucking banger. Aurora was a great way to open the fucking album. It throws you in right into, you know, basically what you can expect for the next 14, 15 songs. Yeah, I enjoyed Art Pop. And I don't think it's because I'm drunk. I think it's because I can kind of see what she was trying to do with this album. And I get it. I do think this album is vocally her strongest album that we've listened to so far. Just the way her vocals were able to overpower the instrumental. That's a hard thing to do, but she managed to do it very, very well. Art Pop as a individual album, great album. I liked it a lot. Art Pop within the range of the three albums that we've listened to so far, I don't know. I'm gonna need a little more time to think about that. But I will definitely let you guys know when I know. But let me know what you guys think. You know, what your favorite song is on the album, what you think about the album as just a conceptual album in general. Make sure you like the videos, guys. Look how much we drank. We drank a lot. Yes, my wife did have two shots, but I had like six or seven. I don't even remember. By the way, this, if you don't know why we did this because we reached 10,000 subscribers before the end of August, I believe. So this video has been a long time coming, and we are already over 18,000 subscribers. And I just want to say thank you, guys. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you from the bottom of my heart for subscribing and supporting me and the channel in the Deep Dive series. It's overwhelming how fast we're growing as a community. And I really do appreciate it. You guys allow me to do what I love to do, and that is to give my opinion on music and share music and explore music I haven't listened to before with you guys, coming along on this journey with me. So again, thank you so much. With that, new videos drop on this channel every week. So make sure you subscribe. Make sure you hit that bell button so you get notifications of when those new videos drop. Hop on over to Instagram, Twitter, and Twitch. Give me a follow. If you'd like to help support the channel, there's a Patreon link down in the description. Go and check that out if you got the time. You get early access to deep dive album reactions, as well as exclusive album reactions, live streams, requests, lots more. Go and check that out. And that's all I got for you guys today. I'm going to go to sleep now because it's late and I'm fucked up. So until next time, take care, stay safe, and I'll see you then.
Hey, thanks for watching Off the Deep End. Make sure you subscribe, comment, like, and share, and feel free to explore our channel and check out some of our other videos. Remember, new videos drop every week. Take care.